England retained the Ashes in Manchester and now they look to secure the series in Durham. It will be their third Ashes series win in a row and they're confident they can secure that little urn up here in the northeast, the home of Graham Onions. He's desperate to get back in the starting 11 and is excited by the prospect of playing in front of his home crowd.
Well, I still feel nerves. I still feel a bit nervous, but it's exciting nerves, really. I mean, it's still the prospect of playing if Test match cricket again, but also playing in front of your home crowd. It's going to be fantastic. You know, if I was obviously given the opportunity to play, it's obviously proven hard to get into this England side, which is great. It's my job to, if I don't play, to go away and play county cricket and try and push my claim as much as I can by pushing the guys in the first team. So, sorry, in the like Jimmy Brodie and Brezzy. So I suppose I'm champing at the bit, as you say, and I'm excited. I feel ready. I'm obviously delighted to be here. Delighted to be part of the squad. If you're in the squad, you're up for selection. You've got a chance of playing. Obviously disappointing in the last game, not to be involved in the squad. But to be here at Durham, where I've played all my cricket, from the northeast, to be very proud to put that England shirt on and. I'm sure I'll get a decent reception, if I was to play. But I suppose, as you said, I feel as though I've played well for Durham this year, and if the chance did come along, I'll be ready.
As is normal in high-profile series, there are off-field distractions, but the players are perplexed at suggestions and unfounded rumours that they could be somehow cheating the hotspot system.
I mean, it's obviously the first I heard when I walked into the change room today, and it seems completely blown out of proportion, really. It just doesn't seem right. And I know that England players would never put anything on their bats. You know, tape's been used to mend cracks or to people have favourite bats to try and last as long as possible. It sounds completely silly to even think that people are putting things on their bats to aid or to try and help them to try and say cover up decisions.
I don't think any of us have done anything with silicone on our bats. We know that we put fiberglass tape on the front, and that's purely for protection of the bat to try and make it last longer. Obviously a lot of people have their favourite bats and put tape and what have you around them, and that's purely to make our favourite bats last as long as they can.
I mean, it's a huge accusation, and it's outrageous, really. I mean, from our point of view, I mean, it was the first time we're obviously talking about it just now in the changing rooms, and obviously the excitement of me getting called up and coming into the squad and seeing the lads again from obviously missing out at Old Trafford, to be involved and have these discussions, it seems a little bit unfair, a little bit wrong, really. So I think we could maybe move on a little bit and try and just talk about this Test match, because the last Test match was a good one. It was close, and I'm sure we're going to have another one coming up now.
There has been some good cricket. It's been very exciting. I think there's been a few decisions that I guess have looked completely different to what the outcome was. But like I said, it's just about getting the right decisions going forward, and that's the technology we've got at the moment that we're faced with, and I'm sure they're going to look for ways to improve it going forward as well.
We've got two Test matches left, and we want to win. We want to win them both. Australia played well in the last Test. They obviously batted well in the first innings, and people say that the rain helped us a little bit in the second innings. But we know opposition's allowed to play well, and Australia are a good side. They've got some great cricketers. Michael Clarke, led by example, obviously scored a good 100. But we showed a lot of character as well to hang on for that draw. And it's, as I said, we've got two games left, and it'll be nice to try and get two results.
What really matters, though, is the cricket. England retained the Ashes in just 14 days, an exceptional achievement. Australia still desperate to try and find an answer, but England are hungrier than ever before to win this next Test and win the series. Barney Douglas for ECB Online in Durham.